Sue Bird, you're one of the coolest humans alive. I'm so happy you're on the show. Thank you so much for being on the show. I just want to go through a couple of your accomplishments real quick. You're a two-time NCAA champion. You're a four-time WNBA champion. You are a 13-time WNBA All-Star. And you're a five-time Olympic gold medal champion. Come on! What are you talking about? Who are you? Who are you? That's just amazing. You're so talented and so good. Out of all those things I mentioned, do you have a favorite that sticks out and you go, yeah, that one was my... it's probably hard to choose.
No, it's definitely hard. This is usually when I'm like, that's like asking a parent their favorite kid.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't have kids, so this is my version of that.
Yeah.
But it is an Olympic year, so I feel like right now, and by the way, my answer changes every time somebody asks.
Okay,
me.
Right,
I keep them on their
because there are all so many things and so many different parts
so many
of your
memories,
life and
so
memories. But what is the Olympics like? Are they just pressure from? I mean, you're the whole country's like leaning on you, going like,
hey
bring us the gold. Yeah. You better do this, yeah. And you're playing against you're one of the 12 of the best in the country, playing against 12 of the best of any other country.
Oh yeah, it's super hard. Honestly, making the team is probably the hardest part, just given how many great American players we have. But for me growing up, there wasn't a WNBA, there wasn't like talks of professional sports for a women's basketball player. So for me, it was the Olympics. So when I finally did make my first Olympic team, that was like my ultimate goal.
Yeah.
And then I remember actually flying back from Athens. You know, we landed stateside and we're all kind of going our separate ways. And I had the medal on me, obviously. It was like in my carry-on. I wasn't wearing it, but it was in my carry-on.
Oh, I would totally have worn
you
it.
You have worn it?
Oh, no. I'm so cheesy. I would have totally been like, yeah, what's up? Come on. You
for
were not,
purposes,
you were humble.
I had to, yeah.
Yeah, of course.
But a flight attendant came up to me and was like, hey, are you Sue Bird? There was a flight to Seattle. I was like, yeah. Do you have your gold medal on you? And I was like, obviously.
Yeah.
I'm not checking that thing.
Yeah, that's pretty cool that she asked.
Yeah, and she was like, the pilots would like to see it. And I was like, I felt pretty, you know, it's a contained area. I was like, yeah, sure. Before I knew it, that medal was like up and down the aisle. everybody
that's
just
cool
wanted
that
to
you gave it.
It.
You let everyone, yeah, of
yeah.
course.
And that's when so the Olympics always meant something for me. And that's when I was like, oh, this is different.
It is, right?
This is
a different level of fame.
Yeah. Everybody's cheering for you. Everybody wants to win, see you succeed. It's a totally different thing.
I'm honored to have you on International Women's Day tonight. You're here. You brought me something, which is so nice. You don't ever have to bring me anything, but this is very, very cool. Can you explain what this is?
Yeah, so myself, three other athletes, Alex Morgan, Simone Manuel, Chloe Kim, founded a company called Together. There's an X in that second E. And this is our media company that wants to shine light on women's athletes. And this is our T-shirt.
Yeah.
It's kind of a play on the fact that people say, yeah, let me give it up. It's a play on people saying,
oh, nobody watches women's sports.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like John 590 from Twitter with no profile pic.
Yeah.
Nobody watches
women's sports. Yeah.
So we're like, actually... And now the numbers show it, which is amazing. So now we actually have data to it. Actually, everybody.
Everyone watches women's sports.
Women's sports.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. You have one for me.
Yeah. One for the girls.
And you got for my daughters as well. That's so thoughtful. Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
I got to say, it's been so exciting watching women's sports recently. Caitlin Clark.
Oh, I know.
Have you been watching? I mean, that is obviously... It must be cool to watch someone like her just start just dominating. You're like, oh yeah, because everyone watched. I think last week that she broke the record, and it was like 4 million people watched that. Mm-hmm. It's just exciting.
Yeah, those are the numbers.
It's huge.
Yeah, she's obviously doing amazing. Her game speaks for itself. I think my favorite part is just women's basketball, women's sports really, but women's basketball has been on the rise, and it's kind of like what Magic and Bird was. To men's basketball, like this moment, we kind of needed something.
This is
to
that
just
moment.
Like, yeah, and Caitlin's that moment. And I think a lot of it has to do with her logo threes. I mean, speaking of John 529 from Twitter.
Yeah.
He's like, oh, women don't dunk.
Yeah.
That's what he sounds like.
Yeah, exactly, of course. Women don't dunk.
Yeah.
That's why I don't watch.
But you can't really talk trash on a logo three.
So a logo three is deep. That's almost half court where the NBA, where the WNBA logo is. Yeah.
Literally where she's shooting from.
Whew, it's just fascinating. Yeah. But I mean, you kind of set the stage for all these athletes to come up and get the attention. I mean, you're the like one of the first big names to just come out and do it. This documentary, Sue Bird in the Clutch, this is fantastic. What made you want to do this?
I think kind of what we're talking about. So women's sports is on the rise now, but, you know, we've had to kind of grind a little bit to get there. And what's been lacking is some of the storytelling. So when I got approached to do this, I was like, all right, I don't know if I'm going to love having cameras in my face all the time, but I felt like I had to do it, right? Like, get my story out there. Hopefully it opens doors for other people's stories. And I really did have an amazing time doing it.
You did, yeah.
Yeah,
you enjoyed doing it. But it was only supposed to be, because you were going to retire.
Joke's on me.
Yeah, you're like, you were going to retire, and then you're like, I'm extending for another year, so now the documentary, now it's 2 years long.
Yeah.
But it's fantastic to see all of those moments of your life in this documentary. Now when people come up to you, go, what was your favorite moment? You go, watch the documentary, and you come back with your answer. Yeah. There's so many in the clutch moments for you, very clutch moments where the pressure's on. One of these is this shot you made. It was in 2001, the Big East Championship game.
Yeah.
Do you ever watch this clip?
It's part of my my nighttime routine.
Yeah, you watch on YouTube, you watch all your greatest hits. You're like, all right, I'm going to sleep now. All right, that's it. I'm awesome. What do you remember about making that shot?
So this one I vividly remember. It's probably my first, like, big moment. And what I actually remember, two things. One, I had turned the ball over, the possession before this shot.
Oh, no.
And so I was like, oh, my God, they're all going to kill me. Like, I'm done. The coaches, everybody.
You let everyone down. This is it.
So there was really no, I was like, I have to make this. I have to make this.
How old are you now?
I'm like 19, 20 years old.
Yeah,
I'm a baby. And then the second thing I remember watching it later is that Robin Roberts and Doris Burke were on the call. So I have this amazing moment, and the soundtrack to it is Robin Roberts saying, she did it! And Doris Burke being like, big time!
Yeah! let's take a look. Here's Sue Bird going for the winning shot at the buzzer in 2001. Take a look at this. Amazing.
And she makes one of two.
You're a legend. Please come back whenever you want. We love you.
Thank you.
Sue Bird, everybody, check out In the Clutch on Apple TV and Amazon Prime Video beginning March 29th. More Tonight Show after the break. Stick around, everybody. Hey, hey.